coming up.
Good morning and welcome to this vlog. This is Maraka part 2. Yes, I just finished bathing. My dad just pulled up for the trailer, so yeah, we're going to the cattle post just to see how things are. And we're taking the Modisa's house with us. So yeah, let me take you guys along.
Ish. Hello guys, and welcome to another Maraka vlog. Well, you guys really enjoyed the previous Maraka vlog, so I thought, you know what, let me take you guys, even though I'm not doing much on this one. I have flu, so excuse me. Started off by having breakfast. Yep, most important meal of the day before helping up with packing and loading the trailer.
We just finished loading up the trailer and yeah, just final touches and we'll be leaving.
Because of the added weight, fuel consumption was very, very high. We stopped by Choppies and Kopong to get a few items for the farm workers and a few snacks for the road.
It's a camping chair.
Yeah.
Are you crazy?
Yeah.
And she's not crazy.
She's not crazy.
Finding everything we needed here in Kopong Choppies, we hit the road. Destination Molepolole Village.
Papa.
You ate me.
Yes. Because you are naughty, 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 naughty.
You ever beat my mom. I'm gonna.
Entering Molepolole Village using the A12 road was always a delay because of this beautiful house here. I love it, it's beautiful. You, Botswana, have money.
After filling up the car with diesel, we headed into the Molepolole village. At the time of filming, the mall just by the engine didn't have any working ATMs. Yo, Molepolole roads are terrible. Yo, the potholes, but the roads don't exist. One of the best childhoods I had was here in Molepolole, so driving around the village was making me very, very nostalgic. What a lovely place.
The mother's quite
careful. Why would the mother's question?
We found ATMs by Shoprite Mall and we immediately headed out of the village to Marak. A trailer check is important for every 100 kilometers done.
How are you so sad? A quick stopover for pictures by a watering hole that is by the Sojourner Tern. You know how we are when we see water. It's always pictures. For the past 4 years, this place has been dry and it started filling up recently.
If you love Siswasa Puti and Magwinya coffee cakes, this is the place to be. I highly recommend it. This year was Otse Village, so we bought some food and hit the gravel road. Village, we took the cut line that headed all the way to Adishia, but didn't go all the way through. somewhere close to Mkhanene. Leaving the cut lines means overgrown bushes, so it is important to keep trimming them to make for a better way.
As luck would have it, the tool we used to cut off overgrown branches broke. Oh, quick question, would you rather have me narrate or boring old Bogo?
Yeah.
We arrived at Moraka, or the cattle post, and the trailer was unloaded. Okay, bye.
Bye indeed. That was your last narration, unless people want otherwise. We walked to one of the kraals or masaka where the calves or marole way to go and put in ear tags for identification. We use ear tags or and a TP, which is burned into the skin. But unfortunately, they were too small to have the second one done to them.
The ear is also nicked as a way of identifying it. After everything was done, the marole was set free to go and graze. Record keeping is very important, so we immediately registered them into the government system. At this point, there was nothing more to be done, so we packed and left for the city.
You just love Botswana sunsets. Remember to like, share, and subscribe to Bobo's channel. Bye!